Welcome to the head coach's office. This is in the new coach's suite. And basically this area is a spot for the head coach to meet with players, meet with families, and have a little area where you can kind of separate yourself and have some privacy. And you know, when we built this office, the thought was that basically a lot of this was going to be used for recruiting, because in my thought process, collaboration between staff is going to be really important, and always has been really important. So a lot of the work we do as a staff is outside this office, but this is a great place to meet with players or families. And basically, if we had a family on a recruiting visit, they would be sitting exactly where you are. And the office has some spaces, areas. It's got some great couches with Wildcat logos on, just to give you a feel for that you're in Wildcat hockey. A couple things on the wall are just parts of who I am. I think the man in the arena is a great speech. My wife had one made for me at Teddy Roosevelt, and it just talks about, you just competing is basically the theory behind it. Some people win, some people lose, but you want to be the man in the arena that knows defeat and knows victory, and you know you lived when you have those emotions. So, you know, I want that to be present for our families and our players when we come in here. And then when you get to talking about, you know, where your son would play in our program, we can open up this area right here. And basically what we could do is have our lineup up for the upcoming year and who's on our team. You know, so maybe your son is, you know, is a center, and Joe Nardi's graduating, and on the left wing you have Griff Lochran, and on the right wing you have Andre Gontos. And Griff led the league in scoring last year, and Andre's leading the league in scoring this year. So if we think your son's going to be a player that could fit in that position, you can have all these players up. And if maybe he's a defenseman, or he's a middle six player or a goaltender, now they can visually see in our program where they fit. And also what this can be used for is player meetings. So if you have a player in and you're doing video on the TV, you can show him something on the board if you have to. So multi-purpose area, great for families, for recruiting, and great for our team and our program for individual player meetings. As we walk out of the office and into the main coaches area, this is where a lot of our work gets done. And you know, a lot of things, basically day-to-day work is done. There's workstations for all three coaches. So you know, there's a spot for all of us to sit, myself, Rob, and Byron. And we'll sit there and do some individual work. But basically the day starts every day, and we come over to the conference table, and we have notes of whether it's players we want to recruit, whether it's things we need to do in practice, or whether it's something that, you know, you're watching video and it just grabs your attention. So you put it on the board and you go, okay, I got to look for that again, or something just the staff we want to talk about. And then you get to the lineup, and that, you know, this is something that, you know, is always in flux in this program. You know, the elevator's going up and it's going down, and you're always trying to find the best line combinations. And sometimes there's guys that play, you know, exceedingly well for 3-4 weeks, and then you need to change it up again. So just gives you a nice visual for it. And then obviously the rinks for doing, you know, whatever you need to do. Maybe you have, you know, somebody's first power play here, their second power play here, how they want to run their breakouts, and maybe you have what you'd like to do over here. And that might be a typical day of what you're doing if you're working on the other team's power play. One area that really has been beneficial is this conference table, where the coaches can sit around it, and we can use the TV, and we have all our projections here, so you can have your computer and project on the TV whatever you're working on that day, and all of us can sit here and see each other. It's also used for post-game video, so after a game we'll come in here and you know, go over the video and again write notes and talk about things that we're doing. But the other thing that, you know, basically what this can be used for, and we haven't had a chance to do it yet because of the NCAA recruiting rules, there's been a ban on families and players coming to campuses, and you know, that's going through April right now. So it started last year in May, and it's going through April, with the possibility it may get extended, but at some point it's going to be open again. And imagine sitting at this table with a player and his parents, and you know, maybe we have the lineup projected there, or we have something else that we want to show on campus that's there. Hey, here's what we're going to go through today, and follow us that way, because that's one thing we have really taken advantage of is virtually showing campus. And I don't know that There's very few campuses that show as well as ours does. So it was disappointing we couldn't take families around and show them, you know, the Northern Center and the new dorms and Jamrich and some of these new beautiful buildings. And then obviously the town and the community and the lake and all those things. But we can show that stuff virtually now. So we're doing a lot of that on Zoom meetings, but we will keep some of that for recruiting in the future. And then this area is where the coaches will get changed every day for practice. And, you know, basically, this is a replica of what the player stalls will be. You know, they will have one addition. These are going to be backlit, so when they walk in, this will be backlit. And then down in the bottom of the drawer, there's going to be an end, you know, the northern end. So really looking forward to, you know, the future of Wildcat hockey. And, you know, this is just a glimpse in the next 20 years. It symbolizes the future. I mean, it's a gateway for us into the next 20 years of what we're doing. And you look around this office and when you come to work every day, you know, just how fresh and clean and productive it can be in here. You know, and really through the process, the locker room was gonna be first. And the pandemic actually gave us a little bit of a break because we learned a few things in the coach's office that you just wouldn't foresee. It's like building a house. When you build a house, there's something you miss. So this gave us a chance to kind of tweak a couple things that way. And I can't wait for the players to be able to walk into a space like this. And theirs is even gonna be on a whole nother stage. Like it's gonna be one of the best locker rooms in college hockey. And you know, that is kind of the final piece for us, you know, and everything else we have is right first class, top tier from, you know, from the campus to the community, to the way that our players are treated, to the way we travel. You know, this is the last piece and now you can see it coming. I feel so fortunate to be coaching a program that has had so much success and has had so much support. And You hear about, you know, different eras of Wildcat hockey and the fans and the characters that were part of it and the donors and, you know, and those people have become a little bit of lore around the program. And, you know, I think this is the next phase of it. And obviously we have had great support, you know, locally. We've had great support from major donors outside of town. But we're still building this program. We're still building this locker room, and there's still locker rooms to be sold, and there's still changing stalls to be sold, and you know, there's going to be great years of Wildcat hockey. You know, when I'm here, and hopefully in 25 years when I'm gone, but my name's going to be there, and you know, there's going to be a player that comes through this program, and he sits in that stall, and he goes, "Huh, who's that person?" And you know, there'll be a story. Like you're supporting who that player is. And that to me was why we were interested in it. And I think, you know, there's opportunities for people at every level. And it's something that as a player and a donor and that, like that connection, you know, I always thought is what is the pageantry of college athletics. That's what makes it different than professional sports, is the passionate fans and that connection between fans or donors and the student athlete. And anytime I can be part of that, I wanted to. We're a big time program. And you know, I think as you look at the history of, there's been winning here, there's been NHL players, you know, there was a realignment in the leagues. And you know, I think when that happened, everybody was trying to sort out where we all fit in the world. And from that point, there's been some programs like us that have now invested in their program. And they are legitimate big time programs. And we are, you know, on our way to becoming that. And obviously it's your performance on the rink. But you also need the support of administration, which we unequivocally have had. You know, from the moment that I've gotten here, the support we have gotten has been incredible from the absolute top down. The support we get from alumni is just, you know, whether it's Don Waddell or Dallas Drake or Justin Florek or Doug Garrow or, you know, whoever, like that, just the ability to contact and communicate with them has been great. And then, you know, the donors and the fans, you know, all those things combined together are the culmination of what this locker room is. And, you know, the culmination of what's pushing us into this category of becoming a big time program.